Hold your breath. Make a wish. Count to three. Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look, and you'll see into your imagination.
Do you think it's a bit self-indulgent to do an unboxing of my own work? It's a bit late now, isn't it? Hello, YouTube. So this is going to be the first video uploaded for the GTC channel. So I best introduce myself. My name is Mo, and I started Golden Ticket Customs. I've been customizing now full time for about half a year, October, November, almost 8 months. Jeez. So this is going to be an unboxing for a pair of Wonka themed AF1 highs that I did. The commission was for a birthday present for the client's brother's 50th, who by all accounts is a big Wonka head himself. Wonka head. That doesn't sound right. Wonkaholic? He's a Wonka fan. He's a Wonka fan. So, about the shoes. The shoes were an AF1 high top and obviously a Wonka theme, like we said. The client said I had pretty much free reign to do what I wanted with the shoes. They did have a couple of requests of what they wanted on it. A picture of Wonka, at least one. A Wonka bar, a golden ticket, an everlasting gobstopper, an Oompa Loompa or two. And they also wanted the quote, "The snozzberries taste like snozzberries somewhere." So the majority of that stuff I was going to put on anyway. And they said the design was free range, which is always nice as an artist. Especially doing something that is so close to your heart, it kind of gets you a little bit excited about the shoes and getting them done. As it was a 50th birthday, there's a request that I put the 50th and the date of birth on it somewhere as well. But after discussing that with the client, we decided that it'd be best not to put it directly onto the shoe. And we came to an agreement to put it onto the box. And obviously I customized the box to kind of get customers a little bit more excited when they're opening up the box to have a little bit of an engagement with the shoe before it's even opened. That's pretty much it, isn't it? All right, let's open up some shoes.
So before the shoes, we'll have a quick look at the box itself, which is itself customized. For big projects like this, I think it's always a good idea to present them as best you can to get the customer excited about the contents of the box before they even opened it. So with this particular box, we have the golden ticket up front, we have the 50th birthday and date of birth on it, and it's hard to see on this video, but the golden ticket itself has this holographic glitter in it, so it's quite shiny off the light. Then we have a couple of the decals around the box, the Wonka silhouette, the Oompa Loompas, and the Wonka W. But by far the best part of this box is the rig setup that I have for when you open it. As you can probably tell from my smug reaction, it's my favorite part of the box. So just using one of those music cards, I've rigged the box so that when it opens it plays Pure Imagination, and then on the inside I have my golden ticket branding and a print of the mural that I did, and then finish it off with some simple crepe paper, and then into the main event, the shoes. So straight off the bat, front and center, we have the big man himself, William S. Wonka, and he is beside a Wonka bar on the inner panel. So two of the requests ticked off straight away. Of course, it is Gene Wilder's Wonka that we're talking about here. If there was anyone out there that thought Johnny Depp when I said William Wonka, then it's probably past your bedtime. I like Johnny as much as the next guy, but he can't hold Gene's everlasting jockstrap when it comes to Wonka portrayals, and I think Johnny knows that. Speaking of everlasting, we have an everlasting gobstopper here above the golden ticket wrapped around the heel. And then on the inner swoosh, we have the Wonka candies from the chocolate room. Trying to keep it true to the movie with candies such as the magic mushrooms, and they're all in front of a load of bubbles from the bubblegum scene. So with the lettering around the shoe, I used this color shifting paint I've never used before, and I really like the effect that it draws out of the shoe. The quote itself is my favorite quote in the movie, and I really like how it coincides with the quote that the customer requested, which you'll see later in the video, the other shoe. We are the music makers, we are the dreams of dreams, is what it says. And it's nice when it's a one of one, being able to put on your own little touch and what you like into the shoe. Now, no Wonka theme would be complete without a hot tip to everyone's favorite creepy, teeny tiny orange fat shamers. So, we've got a little panel here with two dancing Oompa Loompas. Have a little listen to what they say in the song.
What are you at, getting terribly fat? What do you think will come of?
You definitely couldn't get away with calling little kids fat like that these days. But I suppose a story about an eccentric millionaire luring kids to his mysterious factory with the promise of free sweets is a pretty hard sell in this climate too. Guess it was just simpler times back then. So like I said, I tried to keep the inner swoosh like the Wonka candies. And then that brings us to the quote, the snozzberries taste like snozzberries. I really like that in the film, both the quotes are one after the other, the snozzberries and then the dreamers of dreams.
The snozzberries taste like snozzberries.
Snozzberries? Who ever heard of a snozzberry?
We are the music makers, and we are the dreamers.
Yeah, I just love how it worked out that my favorite quote and the requested quote are one after the other in the movies, and you know, side by side in the on the shoes. Just worked out very well. And then my favorite part of the shoes is definitely the toe boxes. On the left, you've got the pieces, the squares of chocolate. On the right, you have the opened chocolate bar. I wanted to feel like the scene where Charlie opens the bar and sees the golden ticket for the first time. And just the way they worked out, I just think that they look great. The big wide toe boxes made for good chocolate bars, to be fair. Now, having a little peek on the inside of the shoe, which could be giving the toe boxes a run for their money, is the psychedelic souls. I wanted to portray the boat ride scene from the movie and add a little quote in there that I know the customer was a fan of.
Way of knowing which direction we are going.
Both the souls and the laces are products from a company called Mr. Lacey, which I got through sportsdirect.com. I'll leave a link in the description. Lastly, this is really just to see any other customizers that are out there. I want to share a little technique or a tip that I'd used for the first time on these shoes. I guess anybody that has removed ticks knows that once you pull off the seams and rip the stitching, it's left you're left with holes. And I don't really like the finish when you're painting over these holes. So I tried with this little leather filler stuff, flexible leather filler, and injected it into the holes, and it leaves a little bit of a residue above, and it's just sanded down, and it leaves a much finer finish. So then once I've put down a base coat, painting onto this panel, it just leaves a much smoother finish, and there's no holes on the outside that you can see. And it's a little something that I just don't see anybody doing, and I just wanted to share because I have learned most of my stuff through YouTube, and it's a great platform to share this sort of stuff.
The paints I used to make this shoe are from AngelusDirect.com. They make by far the best quality leather paints on the market, in my opinion. The finish was from Liquid Kicks. It gives it that factory look, and some of the additives from Golden, and I'll leave all the links in the description below. Hopefully we'll be making a few more videos like this if you guys like them, and we'll leave you with the customer's reaction of him unboxing them. And of course, if you like what you see and you want to see more, Instagram, Golden Ticket Customs, and YouTube. Don't be afraid to share that stuff around.
That's coming from the box.
It's coming from the box.
That's coming from the phone.
Oh, for f***ing
sake. They are mad looking. Jesus Christ! What the f***? Snozzberries taste like snozzberries!
And then look at the other one, what the other one says.
We are the music makers, we are the dreamers of the dreams. Jesus Christ almighty!
And then see what it says inside.
Yeah, there's no knowing. Oh, we've all got these, but I never opened on that one.
Yeah.
Jesus, God, these are amazing.